Hi, this is Giuseppe Argenziano from Naples, Italy, and today I would like to share with you a few thoughts about the outcome. You know, when we do skin cancer screening, basically the outcome is very simple. We have three possible choices. So at the end of the examination, we should decide if a given lesion should be excised, it should be monitored, or the patient could simply go home because there is nothing to be worried about. In my estimation, the most important and the most frequent outcome is excision or go home, you know, so black and white. But the intermediate decision, follow-up, so taking time to take a decision, is it should be limited for very specific indications. For example, this is the prototype of patient in which I think follow-up is a great solution. Why? Because we cannot excise anything, we're looking a little bit ugly, and so doing a follow-up is optimizing our skin cancer screening, meaning decreasing the number of unnecessary excisions of benign lesions and increasing the number of early recognized melanomas. Okay, so that's what we basically do today for this kind of patients with multiple nevi. So first we check analogically the skin of the patient. We use a manual dermatoscope because this is the best way to make a diagnosis. Then we compare in our mind the morphology we see in the individual lesions in order to select eventually the lesion which is more ugly or different from the rest of the lesions of the patient. Secondly, we do total body photography. This is more and more important in my mind, in the context of difficult patients with multiple nevi. Total body photography is able per se to increase our chance to recognize early melanoma. And third, we do digital acquisition of 1 to 15 lesions depending on the situation of the given patient. So we do pictures of dermoscopic pictures, and then we do sequential follow-up. So we compare in 3 to 6 months to 12 months the morphology of the individual lesions. Okay. So that's what we basically do for patients with multiple nevi, and that's the best indication for follow-up. In my estimation, nowadays we don't have to speak anymore to when to perform follow-up, but when not to perform follow-up. So in my estimation, it's important to know that we should avoid following up lesions which are palpable, which are elevated on the skin. Second, lesions with extensive regression. These lesions are not good ones to be monitored. And then globular lesions, if we see lesions mainly typified by globules, this is also not a good idea to make a follow-up. And last but not least, non-pigmented lesions. So when we have no pigment, it's extremely difficult to understand if a non-pigmented lesion is benign or malignant, and it's if we are unsure, follow-up is not a good solution, it's better to excise, okay? So let me give you an example when we do follow-up without the context of a patient with multiple nevi, okay? So this is a 24-year-old lady, and as you can see, there are some nevi, but this is not an exceptional patient, it's not a difficult patient. There are some small congenital nevi, but particularly there is a lesion which is a little bit irregular, but it's flat, okay? So a flat lesion could be monitored, okay? Especially, as you can see here, if dermoscopically we see mainly a reticular pattern. So even though this lesion is highly irregular because there is an atypical network, it's not forbidden to take a little bit of time to decide, especially in the context of a 24-year-old young lady, Okay, and here you can see already on total body photography, as I told you before, that there is a striking change over time of this lesion. So definitely this lesion should be removed, and we decided to excise this lesion because of the follow-up, and we found a 0.2 millimeter thick melanoma. Okay, so this is the context of doing a follow-up of a patient outside the context of a patient with multiple nevi. So a flat reticular lesion, because even if it's a melanoma, it's not a problem if we take a little bit of time to make a diagnosis. The thickness will be the same, the prognosis will be the same even after a few months. Okay, so thank you for your attention and see you soon. Bye-bye.